Hi, I'm Tyler Oakley.
And I'm Becca French.
And welcome to Top That, your weekly pop culture cheat sheet to what everyone is and will be talking about on the web.
Each week, Tyler and I attempt to top each other with our own top five of what's hot on the web, everything you need to know.
And we are looking to see if you can top us by submitting your own must-know items in the comments below.
Tyler, you're going first.
Am I going
first? You are. You're
okay.
Going.
Are you ready for my number five?
Look out.
Let's do it.
Summertime.
Ah!
Your lunch!
My number five is actually something like cock-a-doodle-doo.
It's a cock-a-doodle-don't.
Cock-a-doodle-don't. Okay, so there was a news reporter.
Mm-hmm.
He's holding a chicken.
As you do.
And he's reporting hard-hitting news about this chicken.
One of 500 birds that are being judged today.
This chicken starts like freaking out, like nobody has ever held it before and it's just realized somebody's holding it.
Ah!
Pandemonium goes down. You think it's camera shy?
I think it might be a little camera shy.
Well, whatever it is,
and
it's
he probably
not
was like, "This
it.
Isn't my best side."
Ah!
You would have the same reaction, would you not?
No, I've been around chickens. I'm from the South. Okay, like you know what I'm saying? Get
I
it
do.
Together, dude.
I
he
do.
Literally was like, "This chicken's going to take my soul."
Right, and a chicken can't do much, can it?
No, and it wasn't. The chicken was just like trying to have its voice heard.
It isn't my best side.
Ah!
My number five. Guess what?
What?
Chicken butt. It is also a bad chicken. This is a cock-a-doodle-doo. This is a little boy getting just a precious hug from a chicken. He just kneels down, opens his little toddler arms.
And this chicken like knows. Is it a chicken or a rooster or a
hen? This is a hen.
Or...
This is a hen.
How do you know?
Because it doesn't have the like waddle.
I don't care.
You know, and the thing.
I don't care.
Anyways, hen comes in real close, just lays
like
its
lays.
Little hen head.
It's like here for that child.
Oh my God, it is precious. If you have questions about where birds are in the hierarchy of the animal kingdom, take a second with this video. Think about your choices. Tyson.
I will
chicken.
Say I have a heart of stone, and this did it for me. So.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so for my number four, we have plastic unfantastic
mm-hmm.
because we have a man and a woman, both who have had some work done.
I mean, a lot of work
a
done.
A lot of work done.
She's the woman known around the world as the real-life Barbie. She needs a partner. A real life Ken.
Two entities have lived their lives getting plastic surgery.
Separate.
Separate. They've never met, but they have finally come together, and it wasn't as peaceful as one might think.
A formal, awkward handshake made it clear that sparks would not be flying between these two as they both broke out laughing.
You know, listen, they're plastic. It takes a little bit to warm up.
Much of her look is added makeup, fake hair, and slimming corsets, Justin is quoted as saying. Drag queens have put on the same illusions for years. Justin said bad things about me, but he had more than 90 operations, while I had only one. He would do better not to comment on who is plastic and who is not.
Hashtag awkward, hashtag love at first. Maybe it's love at second sight.
Yeah.
Give him some time.
My number four, can you smell what the club is cooking? I have Jamaican nightclub daggering meets world wrestling entertainment.
Look at this! Oh my God!
Okay, I'm gonna drop some knowledge on you right here.
Okay.
Daggering is a form of dance that involves dry sex, wrestling, and other forms of frantic movement.
No, don't do this!
So imagine daggering, which again, you know, pulls from wrestling, but now they're taking like literally the voiceover from a wrestling match and putting it on top of people in nightclubs doing redonkulous daggering.
16-foot line! Oh, I did it!
Just put your eyeballs on it.
Don't do it, Undertaker! No!
There really aren't any words. You
I
just
think,
need to be there.
Yeah, this is the next step in a relationship. This is fifth base.
Oh my goodness! Oh my God!
Is this what straight people do?
This is what we do. This is what we invented. Because we got bored.
Y'all can have it. Okay, so for my number three, we have the action movie kid. And
oh,
this kid
so
is adorable, but B, blessed, because his father is one of the most skilled special effects artists of our generation.
You forgot your lunch.
He's taking basically home footage of his kid and turning it into the most epic movies and like short clips of all time. It's like him jumping from like the sofa to the couch.
And there's like lava. Like,
actual lava, because you know, like you used to play that as a child.
Obviously.
Or like he has like a lightsaber in a store and it is an actual lightsaber. He's basically just taking this kid's imagination and making it real.
Boom, boom, bam. I got him!
And even though we don't have the best special effects per se,
we can do a little bit of something.
You think?
Yeah, like.
And like.
Ooh, let's have a sword fight.
If nothing happened, we ran out of budget.
Okay, so sorry.
Sorry about it.
All right, my number three, another amazing illusion. We have Sippin' on Gin and News from Brian Williams.
Okay.
Okay, so Jimmy Fallon delivers yet again another amazing montage of Brian Williams somehow rapping Gin and Juice.
With so much drama in the LBC, it's kind of hard being Snoop the old double G.
The Katy Perry song.
Okay.
The lyric?
It is a lyric, it is not a song. That is Snoop Dogg.
California Girls.
Get it together.
Oh my God, what a jam.
Get it together.
Somehow, some way, keep coming up with funky ass shit like every single day.
How much time does it take to like find all these little snippets?
Rolling down the street, smoking and dough, sipping on gin and juice. Laid back with my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
I want them to make little snippet videos of us rapping things.
Oh my God. Wait, I'm sure somebody at home can do
literally,
that.
We're like putting all this work. We're like, can you give us special effects?
Yeah, wait, yeah.
And also I want to rap.
I want to rap.
So.
Make us sing.
Mm-hmm. What should we do? Ooh, Turn Down for What would be fun.
Okay.
But there's not really many words in that. Look out.
Turn down
for what? Turn down for what?
Magic of editing. Okay, so for my number two, we have Collabro. This is a boy band that came to Britain's Got Talent and auditioned. And you know, the panel is always skeptical. After
right.
One Direction, they're like, nobody is gonna be on that
they're
level.
They're like, don't even try.
Don't try. We know your game. We know why you're here. And they're like, we're good, thank you. You can audition, but in advance,
so they're just like basically
good.
Side-eyeing these guys.
Right.
They're like,
we've been together for about a month now.
A month? Oh, not long. What makes you think after a month that you're good enough to win Britain's Got Talent?
But then the music starts and these boys have voices on them that are just like incredible.
Angelic.
They're singing a song from Les Mis and it's basically just music to everybody's ears.
Yeah,
you can see the entire audience.
Legit like, musical theater. You fall in flame, and so it must be, for so it is written on the door.
Oh, wonderful
yes.
Melodies.
And the faces don't hurt.
Right, and they're pretty cute.
Pretty cute. Safe behind bars,
I will never rest. All the judges are like, oh my gosh, if this is what you did in like 2 months, imagine what you can do on the show.
To have all four judges on their feet as well at the end.
Yeah.
Something special, that, you know?
Yeah. When Simon stood up, I was like, yes.
My number two, while we're talking about bros, we must cover Brozen.
Oh my God.
Okay, so these baseball players from the Naval Academy.
Oh my God.
Decided to do a little lip sync as they were driving, which I'm not sure is safe, but whatever, to Love is an Open Door. It is on point.
Brozen is the technical term for a bro who likes Frozen, like myself.
Mm-hmm. Obviously. I mean, look at this bro over here. Is there anyone broier than this? These guys really, though, add some theatricality.
Right.
You know?
And there's nothing like some, like, hot, manly
baseball players.
Men.
Shout out to the guy who pokes his head out at the end and just kind of reacts to the engagement because we all
super
wanted
cute.
To react to that engagement. We all were like, too soon.
Will you marry me?
Can I say something crazier? Yes.
Okay, so for my number one, we have to talk about the viral sensations. Basically, the new Rebecca Blacks, but it's a duo. It's a collab called Summertime is Great, and it seems...
Oh, what a title!
Right, right. Okay, well, just hear me out, okay? I don't even know how to discuss this, because it is a video that's gone viral, but not in the, like, the most favorable ways.
Like, in the reverse, like, oh my god, this is so ridiculously bad.
Summer vacation is here. Gonna ride my bike, gonna go somewhere. It's my favorite time of year.
It's
summertime, and isn't it great? It's summertime when everything's great.
I think what's going on is a brother and sister, and I think their father is involved.
Family affair.
It's a family affair. They are basically singing about why summertime is great.
Barbecues in the backyard, trees are over me. Nothing is hard.
You need to watch it. It's
summertime.
You can always tell when somebody's trying to be bad at something.
You think they're not trying.
They're not trying. It's
so there's no self-awareness, which honestly, the internet loves when somebody doesn't realize.
Free to be just what I wanna be.
These people don't realize.
You know?
Doing what I want. And staying up late.
What do you guys think? Do you think this is real? Do you think this is like staged? Do you think this is some type of marketing ploy?
Well, it always blows my mind. I find it refreshing when people aren't savvy, you know? Like, I'm like,
these two don't seem savvy.
Everything is just so fine.
And this was actually viewer submitted from Tess Glimmerveen. You wanted us to talk about it, but you know, I had to talk about it, so we were on the same wavelength.
My number one, One Direction. This is, of course, user submitted by like 1,000 people.
From Arizona Steel, though.
Arizona Steel.
Thank you, Arizona.
This is the You and I, the new video, where the boys are on a dock. It starts with Niall, right? And he's singing. And then he morphs into Liam.
I know how it goes. I know how it goes for wrong and right.
And then we get Liam, who goes into, I think, Harry?
You and I, we don't wanna be like them.
And then after Harry, we get Zane.
Very impressed with you
right
now.
And then Zane Louie.
See what it's like. See what it's like for day and night.
Yes, I've watched it a couple times. Honestly, my favorite part of the whole video is probably the sweater. One sweater to rule them all.
You're welcome.
Obviously. And I think we need to talk about Liam's beard in the comments. Let me know what you think.
Let us know what y'all think.
Okay.
If you like this week's episode, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to Pop Sugar Girls Guide for more episodes of Top That every single Friday.
Tyler, did you have fun in this countdown?
I did.
Do you want to go hug a chicken?
I do. I was like, where are you going with anything?
You're like, what's happening
next? That is actually
next?
Where I need to go right now. So it's been real.
Yes.
We'll see you guys next time.
Oh, and Brozens, hit us up.
Hit us up. Okay, bye.